In this video, we will cover electrolysis calculations. And before we get into the setup or examples of them, there are two things that we need to define that will be used in our calculations. One is the unit of our current that is passed through an electrolysis apparatus. So our measure of current is assigned the variable A, which stands for amps. So we'll be told how many amps are passed through, or we can calculate how many amps. And then from that, amps are then broken down as a ratio of how much charge in coulombs. So that capital letter C represents our charge in coulombs over time, specifically in seconds. Best thing you can do as you're working on calculations or see a problem referring to amps, as soon as you see amps, convert that into units of coulombs per second, or C over S. The other thing to clarify is that we will again be using Faraday's constant, but notice the difference in units. When we used it in our calculations before, we had it in units of joules per volt per mole of electrons. But if you remember from our introduction of this constant, that unit of joules can be, or sorry, joules per volts can actually be converted directly into coulombs. And so equivalent value would have units of coulombs per mole of electrons. This version of Faraday's constant is also on your equation sheet. Both of these constants are under the constants on your equation sheet. All right, so a practice calculation. We want to know what mass of iron can be produced when 45.2 amps is passed through a molten iron 3 chloride cell for 1.5 hours. The general setup for the calculations we're going to do are found over here. For the most part, we're essentially just doing dimensional analysis, just setting up units, keeping track of what we have and where we want to, or how we need to set them up. As a starting point, we need to figure out our equations. So again, remember, we're starting with molten iron chloride, iron 3 chloride. And the easiest first step is to break this down into, so used to writing aqueous, break this down into our two ions in there. We're only interested in the iron because that's what we want to solve for. So I only need to worry about that equation. And remember, my product is going to be the elemental form of iron in the liquid state, but still elemental form of iron. So to balance this equation, I have to include my 3 electrons on the reactant side. So this tells me that iron is actually going to be at the site of reduction, in other words, the cathode. To show you both equations, here's the iron one. If I wrote the chloride one, it would look like that. Our overall balanced equation is here. I never ask for that overall balanced equation. The key thing you need to worry about is how to write the correct half reaction. All right, so on the next slide, I'm going to work through this problem. And we were given amps. So I'm immediately going to convert that into coulombs per second. So my next step then is I need to cancel my seconds. I'm going to multiply by the amount of time. But of course, hours and seconds don't cancel, so I need to convert my hours into seconds. You could do this all as one step if you wanted to. If you just wanted to write the time in seconds immediately, feel free to do that. And you don't need to calculate at this point, but I like to, just so I can kind of see where I am numbers-wise. Keeping extra digits because I don't want a rounding error later. I have this set up. So I know how many coulombs have been produced by my electrolytic cell. My next step is to actually use Faraday's constant now to convert to moles of electrons. All right, Faraday's constant is the only other place where we have that C or the Coulombs. So my C cancels out. Now I know how many moles of electrons got transferred in this cell over this amount of time. And now I'm going to use my stoichiometry to convert my moles of electrons into moles of the iron that I want to solve for. And if you remember from our balanced equation on the previous screen, my moles of electrons to the product moles of iron. So I have a 3-to-1 ratio. And then, of course, our last step would be to convert our moles of iron into grams, right? We wanted to know mass. And so we look up the molar mass of iron. When we calculate all of this, our final answer is going to be reported to sig figs. Again, going back to our original question, we had 3 sig figs in both of our quantities. And so for our final answer, we calculate 47.1 grams of iron that can be obtained from this process. So a couple of key things. One is, again, remember in here, we are using stoichiometry from our balanced equation. So we do need to know how to write that. And then we are using the molar mass of the element that we are solving for. In this case, it was the iron. In your slides, I have the full worked out solution here. So there's the nice typed version of what we just set up. And then as another practice problem, the other variation in an electrolysis problem is essentially to work backwards. So notice here again, we're given the amps, how much current is passed through. But now we want to know how long it's going to take to produce a certain mass of copper. So what I recommend you to do is, again, to cover the answers that are given here. Practice writing the half reaction and then work on your setup for this one. One key thing to note, I ask how long it takes, but I don't give units for that. And so you're welcome to report your answer in any units unless I specify of time. So hours, minutes, seconds, whatever. All right, good luck practicing that. That is the last of our calculations for our electrochemistry chapter. The next video that I'm going to post will be on examples of batteries.